Hi everyone, it's Kathy Rose Creations. I'm starting another project and it's kind of involved. I've been marinating it in my head for a couple months now and I kept thinking about it and what I wanted to do and how I wanted to do it and what I wanted to use, what materials I wanted to use. And now it's kind of come together. Originally, I was going to do a big canvas, like 16 by 20, which for me is big. But then I decided to use two 8 by 10 canvases. These are just inexpensive canvases from Daiso, the Japanese dollar store, 8 by 10. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to be doing two collages using paper and fabric. I have tons of different kinds of fabric here, and there's a still photo that I'll stick in the middle of this. And I have tons of different paper. You can kind of see it off to the side here. And the reason I have these divided is because I want similar on each one. It's not going to be exact. It's going to be complementary. And it'll be a combination of the paper and the fabric. We shall see. If it turns out crappy, oh well. I'll send it to Goodwill. Okay. I debated about whether or not to paint the edges of the canvas or cover them with something. And I have decided to paint them with this Elegant Finish Metallic Paint. If you've seen my videos before, you know I just love this stuff. I have silver, I have gold, and this one is called Rich Espresso. And I like it because you get lots of it. There's 10 fluid ounces, which is a lot. And it lasts a long time, and it's much cheaper than some of the other metallic type paints. So I really just love it. And I'm gonna paint the edges that. If I don't like it, I can always cover them with fabric or paper. So, you know, it's not a permanent solution if it's ruined. And some of the things I'm doing are, first of all, let me show you something here. This is my paint sample collection. Shannon, I don't have a big Bertha. I have a big box. No, it's not a big box. It's a box. But I have, every time I go to the store, Walmart, Home Depot, Lowe's, one of those places, I grab a handful of paint samples. I grab as many as I think I can get away with. Shannon is not shy. She even asked for a bag. Ah, oh, Shannon, you're the queen of scrounging things like that. But I always am looking for, you know, different colors, but I also like the ones that have some kind of a texture. Like this one is kind of a rough texture. And oh, my project's gonna be in all kinds of neutrals. And this one's kind of like a metallic. And you know, I have some other metallics. So that's one thing I'm going to use. And I've been kind of going through the box and picking out what I wanna use. Oops, throw it on the floor and it spilled out. And I took some of them and I put, I took, you know, a larger sample, and then I put some embellishments on it of some sort. This one I'm still working on. And there's this one. So you can kind of see that, for instance, this one here. I wanted to give it some dimension and some interest. And I think I've accomplished that. So we shall see if that is true. And then in addition to paper, fabric, and a lot of the paper, by the way, is handmade or kind of interesting little stuff like this. I don't know if you can see it. It has a raised embossed design, and it's kind of, it feels like handmade paper. I got a bunch of it from Shimmy Dixon. I'll put her link below. She had a giveaway, and I won, and I got a whole bunch of wonderful paper, and I can't remember the name of the company now, but I'll put that on also. And some of these fabrics are things that, if you look at my other videos, and I'll try to put a link up in the corner of the free samples from companies that make upholstery and wallpaper and stuff. Oh, wallpaper. I have a bunch of wallpaper that I received from Artsology, Deb at Artsology, and she had a bunch of grab bags of wallpaper samples, and she picked my name, and I got a whole bunch from there. It was a long time ago, but I was thrilled to get it, and I just kept trying to think of what kind of project to use them in. I was going to kind of make journal covers and stuff, but I got a crap load of journals now, and I'm not putting stuff in them. So I'm going to see what, you know, how I'm going to use them. I've already used a couple of the wallpaper samples. I've cut them up into various sizes. They're very, very pretty. And luckily, I think just about all of the wallpaper samples that she sent me were neutrals. And that's what I was looking for here. Also, at Tuesday morning, twice at Tuesday morning, I found these glass tiles. 99 cents. I mean, you can't beat that, right? All different kinds. And here's kind of like a rust color. Here's little tiny ones. The more little tiny ones. And gray and cream and kind of mid-size there. And I've used a few here and there. They're very nice because they're very interesting. They're self-adhesive, but I usually stick some glue on the back also. And also, I think this was at Tuesday morning also. These are metallic, and they're not brads. They look like brads, but they're not. But they have kind of a raised surface, and there's various sizes, and they're stickers. I mean, they have a sticky stuff on the back. So I thought those might be interesting for something. And I think that's it. I'm going to, maybe I'll film and fast forward while I'm working on it, or maybe I'll just come back periodically and show you what I've been doing. One thing I did want to mention, and what did I do with it? There was one piece of paper that anybody who has scrapbooks probably already knows that trick. Well, crap. Okay, let me find it. Sorry about that. Oh, is this it? No, that's not it. Oh, here. It's handmade paper, and it has kind of like fibers in it. I wanted it kind of to be, you know, rough. Well, they're hard to tear because of the fibers, and I didn't want to cut them. So the secret is to wet the edges and then just pull it. Some people lick them. I've had dry throat lately, so I wasn't licking anything. So I had my little squirt bottle of water, and I just put a little puddle in my mat here, and I just kind of dipped them and then pulled them. And it works beautifully. It works for all kinds of those oddball handmade papers that are hard to cut. In the meantime, I will put you on hold, and I'll come back periodically to show you my progress, or I'll fast forward through some of it. I don't know. I've never done a fast forward. I guess it's time to learn, huh? Anyway, I will be back.
Okay, I wanted to show you that I did add some of the little glass tiles and one of the little metallic dufunnies. And here's another one, or another two. And I adhered them with E6000, my absolute totally favorite glue. I've said it before, I could glue a car together with E6000, I think. Anyway, I love it. But I did these. I like the way they look. They're interesting. This one's a little pale. Maybe it needs another little pop of something on it. I'll think about it. Anyway, that's where I'm at now. I'll be back. Hi, I'm back again. I just wanted to show that I made this little thingy here. Well, let me get some white. Okay, this was a piece of fabric that I made a pillow cover out of, and it had all these words and kind of Parisian looking, and you know, the postage and everything. I really liked it. And I outlined the label, it's a wine label, in dimensional paint, really, really thin line. Then I took my Tim Holtz Distressed Crayon, and this one is walnut stain, and I put it along the edge, and then I blended it with my little Tim Holtz blender do funny, and I didn't like it just up against the label part, so I put it on top of some fabric swatch that I had. It was a big square, and it's kind of a houndstooth. And so then I put some more of the Tim Holtz crayon on it, and then I blended it some more. And I like the way it looks now. And I think what I'm gonna do, and I gotta think about it before I do it, because once I do it, it's done. I think because these are complementary pictures or collages, I think I'm going to cut this in half and put half on one and half on another, but I got to think about it first, because once I cut it, I'm not sure I have any more of this fabric, but I want to be careful. I might not. I don't know. Anyway, that's where I'm at right now. Oh, I did make one more little hoochie-dooch here. Okay. And, I cut some fabric that I'm going to use. And like I said, they're complementary, so there's various kinds of fabric. These are all from the samples that I got from various companies. And, you know, anyway, that's what I have. And they're not all the same for both canvases. But they're similar. Some are the same, some are the same fabric, but they're just cut differently, like these two, okay? So, that's where I'm at right now. Okay, put you on hold again. Hi, I'm back. It's been several days, but instead of using a lot of paper in my project, I decided to instead use a lot of fabric and paper. I call it textile collage. Okay, here's one of the panels, and I'm working on the other one. Now, none of this stuff is glued down yet, so I'm going to go ahead and do it off camera, and maybe periodically when I get stuff glued, I'll come back and talk about what I've done. If you'll notice, the label here that I glued onto another fabric sample, I actually outlined it with some Stabila All pencil, and I think a little bit of smudging of Stazon ink. Okay, I cut the label in sort of half, but not. And what's going to happen is when I put them together,
they are going to be, the pictures are going to hang with just a little bit between them, and the label is a continuation. Get that? You'll see when I'm done. Okay, in the meantime, I'm going to again put you on hold while I work on this off camera. I don't want to bore you with gluing crap down because you know how to glue stuff down. But I am making a combination of paper and textiles. Like this is paper here, and this is paper, and this is paper. I mean, this paper's on glued onto paper, and this little bit of paper, this is paper. And it's with the textiles. And then I've got some little wooden, what do you call these? Embellishment thingies. Okay, so I have a somewhat of a Paris theme. So again, I'm going to go off camera. I don't want to have a 45 minute video or two or three parter. It's too boring. So I will go put you on hold and I will come back. See you later. Hi, I neglected to film the last part of putting this together, but here's a flyover of the finished projects. And you can see here the labels. I used a lot of fabric versus the paper. And I put some metal embellishments and some more of those glass squares. And the little label there, I had got a package of those. I think they were at Michael's or something. And they had like a Paris theme. And I stuck a little feather, a real feather, a little piece of straw. There's the feather. Sorry about the little shadow. Thank you so much for watching. Be nice to each other. Peace.